Go ahead and be taking your Bibles and turn to Genesis chapter 6. Genesis chapter 6, we're going to look at verses 5 through 9 this morning. The title of the sermon that I'll be preaching today is called A Godly Father. A Godly Father. And we're going to see the example of this from the life of Noah. In chapter 6, we're going to talk about how he was blameless. He was perfect in his generations. We're going to see that this morning as we look at that. And as we celebrate Father's Day, is a day for you to honor your father, to show your respect for your father. Now, I want to say something about when we look at Father's Day and we look at different special occasions. I think this is a very important one we look at. The reason for it, I believe in our country, we need godly fathers. We need fathers that will step up and take the responsibility that God has given each one of them in their lives. And I believe, beyond a shadow of a doubt, by looking at Scripture and by praying and in reaching out to God, that if we had more godly fathers in our country, I don't believe we would be in the situation that we're in today. And I believe it's very important that we hear this message today, that we understand that we need godly fathers. And I'm going to look at a few traits as we look at this passage of Scripture of what makes a godly father. And there's about five things I want us to see as we look at this passage of Scripture. Number one, a godly father stands out in the world. A godly father stands out in the world. Number two, a godly father finds God's grace. Finds God's grace. Number three, a godly father is just. A godly father is just. Number four, a godly father is perfect in his generations. And then lastly, number five, a godly father walks with God. And I want to ask you the question, and I'm going to be talking to mostly us fathers today, but for everyone, are you living a godly life? For men, are you a godly father? You say, well, I'm not a father yet, but I'm here to ask you, you may be a father one day. Are you preparing to be a godly father? So I want to take your Bibles, go ahead and look at your Bibles, or if you have your Bible app, be looking at that, at Genesis chapter 6. Genesis chapter 6, we're going to look at verses 5 through 9. And this is what the Word of God says. It says, and God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I am created from the face of the earth, both man and beast and creeping thing and the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generations, and Noah walked with God. Let's have a word of prayer. Father, I want to come to you in prayer and pray that you would bless the reading of your word today. Lord, that you would penetrate our hearts and see the need of godly fathers in our country today. And Lord, I pray that you would touch each heart. You would convict it where it's needed, Lord, and that you would do a mighty work today in all of our hearts. And I pray it in the blessed name of Jesus. Amen. The first thing I want us to see is a godly father stands out in the world. A godly father stands out in the world. If you look at starting with verse 5, what the situation was during Noah's time. He said, and God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And I'm here to tell you today that I believe that is what's going on in our world today. We are facing that in our world, that every imagination, of a person's heart is evil continually. And you think about the climate in our world right now. We have so much division. We have so much evil. We have so much hate. We have so much things that are going on in our country and in our world. It's all because of the current situation of sin in our world. Because of this thing called sin, it divides all of us and it causes all these problems in our world. But for a godly father, for a man who is a father to be godly, he should stand out in the midst of all of these things. God was ready to destroy the whole earth. God was ready to pass judgment on the whole earth because of all the sin and corruption that was going on in the hearts of men. It repented God that he made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. He says, I'm going to destroy all man. I'm going to destroy all creature because there is so much sin going on. My brothers and sisters in Christ, there is so much sin in our world today. And I believe God is looking down upon the world and especially our country in judgment. And I believe we don't have long. But we see in this passage of Scripture in verse 8, but Noah found what? Grace in the eyes of the Lord. We see that there is Noah who stood out in a world that was corrupt. Noah stood out in this world that was full of sin. So us as fathers, we can see from Noah that God saw grace in the eyes of Noah, that we need to be different than what the world is today. We need to be different. In what way? Men who are to be fathers, you need to be a spiritual leader. A spiritual leader in this world. And how can you start that? Number one, become a spiritual leader in your home. If you're to be a godly father in this world, I think the best place and the first place you should start is in your own household. Begin at home. Be a spiritual leader in your home. And then number two, the second place you should be a spiritual leader is in the church. We need godly men. We need godly fathers to be leaders not only in their home, but in the church of God. And be different than the people of the world. Be different whether it's popular or not. Be different whether it's popular or not. Don't get in to popularity contest when it comes to being a man or being a father. Do what God wants you to do. Stand out in this world. Be different in this world. Don't be different for different's sake. Be different because you are following and serving and are a godly man or father. And that is something that each one of us as men should be willing to do, is to stand out in this world for Jesus Christ. Stand out in this world for Him. Show Jesus Christ in our lives. Be different than the world. Because what good is it if you're just like the world and you say you're a Christian? So a godly father first stands out in the world because God looked down from heaven and was going to pass judgment, but He saw grace. And that leads us into the second point. A godly father finds God's grace. Look at verse 8. It says, but Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Now, what does grace mean? If Noah was found grace in the eyes of the Lord, what does that mean? Well, I want us to understand what grace is. Grace is unmerited favor. God looked down from heaven. Noah was a sinner just like everybody else. I want us to understand that. But he saw grace through Noah. And he blessed Noah because he followed God. He served God. So God gave him grace. And it's through that grace that Noah was able to do what he did. And that's I want us to understand that a godly father finds God's grace. And in what way? Well, I think first and foremost, beyond anything else, if you're going to be a godly man, if you're going to be a godly father, if you're going to be the person that God looks down and gives grace to, it has to start with a person who is a saved person. If you want to be a godly father today, you can't do it in your own strength. You have to do it through the grace of God. Through God's grace, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who died for your sins and was buried and rose from the dead, you have to come to Jesus Christ and accept the grace that has been given through Him. So if you want to be a godly father, don't try it on your own. Come to Jesus and be saved, because I believe beyond a shadow of a doubt the prerequisite to be a godly father is to be a saved father. Are you saved today? Do you know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? Have you trusted in Him? If you haven't, that is the first step of becoming a godly father. And please don't wait on that. Don't say, let me get my life kind of straightened up and then I can be the godly father that I need to be. No, give everything to Jesus right now in your hearts, because He will change you from the inside out. A godly father starts with a saved man. But I also want us to see a godly father seeks God's grace when he falls short. If you want to know the true aspect of a godly father, is a godly father admits his mistakes. A godly father admits his mistakes. Now, I want us to understand something. Fathers are not invincible. They can't do it all. And for us as men who are fathers, we will fall short. We will sin. We will make mistakes as long as we're here on this earth, because we're living in our flesh. We're not invincible. We can't do it all. But that is where God's grace comes in. That is where the grace of God comes in. When we as men fall short, we admit our mistakes, we confess it to God, He forgives us, and we grow closer to Him as a child of God, and we become a better father because of it. So, a godly father is one that stands out. Noah stood out in the world, and God saw grace. And a godly father is one that finds God's grace, who is saved, who is born again. But also as a Christian, when he falls short, he admits his mistakes and confesses those, not only to God, but to other people. That's something that I believe we as men need to work on. We need to be willing to admit when we're wrong. We need to be willing to admit when we have fallen short and depend on God's grace and ask for forgiveness from Him and maybe from somebody else when we fall short. So a godly father stands out in the world. A godly father finds God's grace. Number three, a godly father is just. A godly father is just. Look at verse 9. It says, "These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generations, and Noah walked with God." First thing in that verse there is that Noah was a just man. What does it mean to be just? Well, I think there's a few things you can include with being just. To be a godly father, you need to be just. And how can you be just? Well, number one, I believe a godly father who is just can make wise decisions. He weighs the decisions carefully. He doesn't just haphazardly choose something because he's the man. He doesn't just make decisions because he thinks that he has all the power, but he thinks through and wisely makes decisions for his family, his church. Make wise decisions. If you want to be a just father and a godly father, make wise decisions. Don't be haste in your decision making. Number two there, not only is he to be having wise decisions, but he's also to be fair in all of his dealings, whether it be with lost people or saved people. Being fair in how he deals with people. You're going to come in contact with all types of people in this world. There'll be lost people. There'll be saved people. There'll be people that look like you. There'll be people that don't look like you. Whatever the case is, you're to be fair in every dealing that you come in contact with. And I believe that's something that's important for us as fathers and as men, to be fair in whoever we're dealing with and whoever we're talking to be a just man. But then lastly in this section, not only is a godly father to be just, he makes those wise decisions, he's fair in his dealings, but he knows right from wrong. He knows right from wrong. A just man knows what is right, and he knows what is wrong. And the just man, a godly father, is one that not just knows it, but he avoids the things that are wrong, and he stands up for the things that are right. He stands up for the things that is right. I'll give you an example of Noah here. Noah preached for many, many years. He knew what was right. He warned people of the incoming flood. But nobody responded. It would have been so easy to say, I give up. I'm not going to do this anymore. But he knew what was right. He made the decision to serve God and to serve him until those raindrops started coming down. And he stood up because he knew it was right. A godly father is a just father. You stand out. You find God's grace. You're just. But then number four, a godly father is perfect in his generations. Verse 9 says this. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generations, and Noah walked with God. It says he's perfect in his generation. I want us to look at this verse just for a second. Now, the word perfect here is not the word sinless. Noah was not sinless. He had to have God's grace. He had to receive God's grace because God saw grace in Noah. But what perfect means here is that he was a man who was mature and complete in his walk with God. So when they say that Noah was perfect in his generations, he was a mature man who served God, who followed God, and took care of his family. He was mature and he was complete. But yet, he wasn't sinless. But he was a perfect man in his generations because he was mature in God. He was complete in God. But also, a godly father that is perfect in his generations is not just mature and complete, but he is above reproach. When a person who is a Christian thinks of your name as a father, what does he think? Can he say, well, that is a great man. He loves God. He loves his family. Or when the name comes up, well, they say, I don't know about that fellow. I don't know about that person. We as godly fathers need to live above reproach. That means do not put ourselves in situations that would taint our testimony for God. You need to be above reproach in all things. And we as men especially, and as fathers especially, need to be above reproach. I've said this before, and this is something I always like to share. One day I'm going to be dead. One day I will not be alive anymore. And somebody would ask the question, what would you want people to say about you when you die? And this is what I said. I said, I pray that I live my life and share Jesus in such a way that when someone thinks about my name, they say, that is a man who loved Jesus Christ, who served Jesus Christ, who shared the gospel of Jesus Christ and loved his family and took care of his family. And that brings us to another thing. We need to be mature. We need to be complete. We need to be above reproach. And we need to be one that leaves a legacy. There's not many things that we'll leave with when we leave this world. We actually won't have anything. You know, Job said, "Naked I came from the womb, and naked I will return." You know, one thing that will follow us after we're gone, one thing that will happen after we're gone, is the legacy that we leave for all the people that remain here on this earth. And ask yourselves the questions, fathers, what kind of legacy are you leaving? So as a godly father is perfect in his generation, he's perfect, mature, complete, he's above reproach, he's one that leaves a legacy, and he doesn't assimilate with the world. You see in this passage of scripture there earlier, it talks about different types of people. And they were blending in, and they were becoming where you couldn't tell the children of God from the children of wrath. You couldn't see the difference between the two. But Noah did not assimilate. He was a just man that kept himself apart for God. And that's what I believe for each one of us as men and fathers today. We need to not assimilate to this world, no matter what pressures are put on us. We need to stand for God. We need to stand for Him. So a godly father stands out in the world. A godly father finds God's grace. A godly father is just. A godly father is perfect in his generations. And then lastly, a godly father walks with God. A godly father walks with God. It says, these are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man. He was perfect in his generations. And Noah walked with God. How do we walk with God? I think there's a few reasons, a few things, on how we can walk with God. Men, I think this is very important. Fathers, this is very important. We need to walk with God. We need to walk with Him every day. How do you do that? Number one, a godly father walks with God because he talks with God in prayer. Godly fathers are people of prayer. Men and fathers today, are we talking with God? Are you praying to God? I think the first thing you do when you rise up in the morning and the last thing you do when you lay your head down at night is you talk with God. You have a conversation with God. You pray to God. You lift up God in prayer. And I'm not saying one of those kind of prayers that you ask for everything that you want. I'm saying it's one of those prayers that you come and give praise to Almighty God and talk with Him and lift His name up and praise Him for who He is. We need men and fathers who can have a relationship with God by talking to Him on a regular basis in prayer. So we need to talk to God. We need to pray. A godly man is a praying man. A godly father is a praying father. Number two, not only is a godly father one that talks to God in prayer, but he communes with God in His Word. We need to be men and fathers of the Word of God. There's so many other voices out there telling us what we need to do, how we need to do it, when we need to do it, but we need to be men and fathers that go according to what God's Word says, and we need to dig deep into the Word of God and apply it to our lives. If you want to walk with God, talk to Him and read His Word. If you want to be godly, talk to Him and get into His Word. Not only is one that talks with God in prayer, communes with God in His Word, but number three, is guided by the Spirit of God. We need to yield to the power of the Holy Spirit. I believe, especially in men, for us as men and us as fathers, I believe that we sometimes do not yield to the power of the Holy Spirit because of our pride as a man. Because of our pride as a man, we don't want to look like this. We don't want to put ourselves out there. We don't expose ourselves. We don't want to show ourselves to the world that we're a follower of God, and our pride gets in our way. But we need to drop pride at the door, and we need to follow and walk with God and be guided by His Spirit. I believe there are many men that are called to serve Him, but because of pride in their hearts, they will not go beyond sitting in a pew or singing a song because they have pride in their heart. And that's not the picture of a godly man or a godly father. A godly man or a godly father is guided by God's Holy Spirit. But then lastly, a godly father walks with God because he talks to God, he reads God's word, he is guided by God's Spirit, and lastly, he shares God by word and deed. If you want to see a godly father, is one that shares Jesus in everything he does and everything that he says. I think sometimes we as men think we get the doing the deeds part pretty good. But how many people have you told about Jesus lately? With your conversation. When you go out these doors, what kind of conversations do you have with people? Do you talk about God? Do you talk about Jesus? Or you talk about everything else under the sun? We can do our deeds. That's fine. And people can see that. But people need to hear our words and hear what we need to say, because we are walking with God. The attitude of your heart should come out of your mouth. And what's your attitude in your heart? So we see a godly father. You need to stand out as a father in this world as a Christian. You need to find God's grace. You need to be just. You need to be perfect in your generations. And you need to walk with God. Let me ask you the question. Are you a godly father this morning? Are you following God with all that you are? If you're not, today would be a day that you need to. Maybe you're here and you need to take the first step. Maybe you need to trust in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. It cannot begin this journey of being a godly father without first being saved. If you're not saved today, come to Jesus. Trust in Him as your Lord and Savior. And then take this road that you need to take of being a godly father. Because you know why? We need godly fathers in this country. What's your need today? You need to come to Jesus. You come to Jesus. If there's any other need, you come to Him today. But I pray that you are a godly father and thank God for the godly fathers in your life. What's your need today? Let's pray. Father, I want to come to you in prayer. And Lord, thank you for this time that we can get into your word. And Lord, I pray that you bless every heart that's heard this message today, Lord. And for us, especially as men, Lord, help us to be the godly men. Help us to be the godly fathers that we need to be. Save those that are lost. Work in those that are indifferent. Lord, do a mighty work in our hearts today. Lord, have your will in your way today. We pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen.